Hey guys, before this video starts, I just want to let you know that the camera's a little bit out of focus, so I do apologize for that, and I hope you guys enjoy the video. Hey, how's it going guys? Welcome back to a brand new video. My name is Alex, and welcome back to the Puck Love channel. Before I start this video, I just want to say, if you'd like to subscribe and come back for a brand new video, that'd be awesome. We're back in my basement where my computer is, so we can do this video. Before I was in my room, and we were recording a few videos there, just to kind of mix it up a little bit. But either way, if you're new, subscribe. I'd like to have you guys back for a new conversation. I'd like to have you back for a new, you know, another conversation. If anything else happens that is controversial, well, come back to the channel. Anyways, that was a terrible advertisement for my channel. Let's go ahead and just take a look at this. Matt Grzelcyk, that's what I'm gonna call him now because I can't pronounce his name, was hit by Oskar Sundqvist. Let's take a look. So here we go. I'm not gonna put the audio because I'm gonna tell Sportsnet to stop copyrighting me. And that's a fact. Anyways, so there was the hit. If you missed it, let me play it back from the beginning in case you missed it. It's very, very fast. There is not a lot of great replays of this. So let's take a look one more time. Here we go. Big hit. Well, not a big hit. I mean, it is a big hit, but it's an unfortunate big hit. And boom, he goes down. Which kind of... There's a fly in my... What the heck? There was a fly. Anyways, look, it's horrible. You don't want to see a guy go down. The next clip you're about to see is a slow motion version of it, which is... before I play it. It's not a good thing to watch because slow motion doesn't do justice to what happened. It gives this bad like reputation and it gives a false representation of actually what happened. So, you know, it doesn't look, it's horrible and it's bad, but let's take a look back here. Right there. I paused it at the perfect time. Right there. That's when I'll try one more time. Grzelcyk. I mean, if it's CYK, it's like Gauchenyuk, so I'll go with Grzelcyk. Let's go with that. He gets the puck and he throws it that way. He kind of loses an edge and he starts tilting downwards, and he gets rid of the puck. And Sundqvist, initially, if we can see, just a frame before. Whoa, that's way too far back. Let's see if we can pause this at the right time. All right, you ready for my pausing skills? All right. He's going in for the hit right here. He already is initiating the hit. You can see his body's towards him, and this is slow motion. So obviously it looks like he could react differently. He sees the opportunity, but it's slow motion, so you can't really say. Let's go back to, and then he goes, and then right there, he's already going in for the hit. This is slow motion once again, and then he goes in for the hit, and he has no time to react. And according to the rules for the NHL, if you are... you know, if you're going to go for a hit, if a player changes his directory of what your original path was to hit the player, and he changes his and he exposes his head to it, it is the player's fault, not your fault, because you initiated contact or initiated the hit when he was not in a vulnerable position. Thus, it is technically not your fault. It is still your job to try and hit as clean as possible, but this was a scenario where it was unfortunate, and you can't react fast enough. It's not human. It's just unfortunate scenario here. Let's go back and watch it from the beginning. I mean, just take a look at this. Just kabooyah. So bad. You know, you watch it in full motion, you think, wow, that's a horrible hit. And it looks like a horrible hit, but look how much time he has. So he's right here now. If you can see my cursor. Yeah. So he's right here, and he's going in, and look how much time. So he's going in for the hit. He's basically officially decided he's going to go for the hit. And this is where Grzelcyk, or Grizz, goes and turns his body downwards. And there's not enough time to react. He was already initiating contact. And it's just an unfortunate scenario. And then Boston, they saw their player down and they went to fight. I don't even know who won this game. I should probably look that up. I have Sportsnet right here. I can load it, I think. Yes. Either way. Oh, it's 2-2 still. It's not even over. There's 1 minute left. It's 2-2. Good stuff, guys. Good stuff. But either way, I mean, it's a terrible hit. It's hard to watch. But it's not his fault. It really isn't. This is just a bad play. And if the NHL really wants to do anything, it's a fine, at least. It's like, you know, a $70,000 fine or something like that. Whatever they do. It's not a suspension. This is not suspendable. This is, you know, it was an unfortunate scenario. His main point of contact was not the head. It's just a really, really unfortunate hockey play. You can't really do it. You can't say anything more. We can just quickly look through the comments. People said it looked bad. They also blamed it on Grizz. Okay, and you know, people are saying that he was instantly knocked out. Well, he wasn't knocked out, but he was definitely dazed, or at least has a concussion now. He left the game, by the way. Yes, the injury has to do with the severity of what will be handed out, if anything does. But once again, like I said, it was a unfortunate play. In his opinion, right call, penalty, yes, 5-minute major, no. Grzelcyk was in a vulnerable position, so that's a good comment. I like it, why not? Marchand needs to escape by Oscar to throw the chicken wing, and then Chin just he turned into it. What? Oh, you mean here. He meant after. Marchand apparently skates by it. I didn't see it. Anyways. It was an unfortunate scenario for both players. He didn't mean to hit him like that, and he turned his body to get rid of the puck, and it was a split-second decision. I always like to emphasize that slow motion does not do justice to any of these plays. I mean, I'll show you it one more time in slow motion. It does not do justice to this. I mean, look at this. I mean, yeah, so, like, slow motion doesn't do anything. It just shows pretty much what people think, you know, oh, he could have did this and this and this split second or whatever, because we're seeing it in slow motion, but it's not the same, okay? So, what do you guys think? Do you think that the NHL will do something about this? Because they've done so many crazy things throughout this series, throughout the playoffs. What do you think? Do you think that they'll hand out a suspension, a fine, or will this just go unthought of, and we will just have a very interesting Stanley Cup Finals with maybe some blood on the table? What do you guys think? Anyways, if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, and like I said, let me know in the comments, what do you think? Anyways, I'll see you guys later.